ladies and gentlemen.
Hey there, YouTube's the mailman coming back at you, and today we are going to be checking out an RSA. An RSA B2K. This thing's pretty badass. It's four chamber B2K BB Vapes brand. I'm pretty sure it's supposed to be brand. It's BRVND, but I'm pretty sure it's supposed to be brand. It's a little upside down A. Now, this thing is pretty badass. You know, this thing is. You can see it on the screen behind me. It's got a lot of accessories. You can kind of check them out just as it is. But we are going to go to the up close. We're going to check this bad boy out. We're going to do a build. We're going to listen to some music. So let's go ahead. Let's head straight to the up close. Let's check this bad boy out. All right, here we are with the up and close. And we got the B2K, Born to Kill, by BB Vapes. Alright. We got the B2K RSA 4th chamber. Okay, this is the packaging that it comes in. It's a nice little tin case. Now, seeing the stuff that it comes with. Oh, there's a lot of stuff in there. Alright, let's go over this. One piece at a time. So now, alright, so this little guy right here. You see that little Ultim piece in there, that is for mouth to lung. And this piece as well is going to be, you know, used in conjunction with that Ultim piece so you can turn it into a mouth to lung RDA. I am not going to be doing that today, but Jay Hayes does have a really good video on that already. And I'll go ahead and link that right above me right there. All right, now that little screw you see there with the O-ring on it, that is going to be for the plugging up the squonk pin on the deck. And you got two extra grub screws. All right, so let's get into, and of course, you know, you got an Allen key. Let's get into this. We'll start with the easy stuff. Okay, you get four pretty much of everything. Now, these are some beauty rings. Okay, we got Ultim, black, white, and clear. Okay. Now, to go along with that, you get four of these 510 with 810 drip tip adapter. We got a drip tip adapter inside of them. Now, I'll go ahead and show you that with this one real quick. Alright, so just pull it apart and there it is. That right there is your 810 to 510 drip tip adapter. Alright, set that aside. Alright, so now we do have this little ring. This is a chamber reducer. Now, I do not like to use this ring for the purpose of, well, I'll show you in a minute, but the top cap does pretty much lock down, but not when you use this. All right, so now that piece right there is going to be a little spit guard for spit back. Okay, it can be screwed in and out. All right, now this little piece right here can be screwed out just like so. Okay, and screw back in. Now that's a spit guard. A spit back guard. You know, in the drip tip. And it can be taken out and it can be used only in the other 810 style drip tips like this one. So as you can see the difference between these two, it will not fit in this one. But it will fit in all of these. Alright. So now, let's go ahead and grab all these drip tips. Okay, so we should have four of each drip tip. Okay. And this one is the 187 rendition, so it does have five top caps. Because you cannot buy the deck by itself anymore. All right, so here is the deck. Okay, we got the 187 rendition. Okay, and let's see. Now this right here is gonna be a plug for the spawn pin. And this one right here is a spare post screw. So you do have a spare post screw on the deck ready to go if you ever lose either of your post screws. Now, the post screws, one's there, and the other is there. Okay, and your leads are gonna go in right here, and right here. Now this is your positive deck, this is your negative deck, and the nice thing about this one is that it gives you this little ledge here. Okay, for you to, and that's where your coil's gonna go, for you to put your coiling rod through and set it. And that's exactly where you want your coil. And as long as you, you know, line it up with there, your coil will go in right every time. All right, so this is the gold-plated deck. Now on the bottom, it's got this O-ring. It's supposed to help with juice. I don't see that it helps at all, but let's see what it says. Everything around me, trap rules everything around me, Treen. All right, pretty cool. And so we got a gold-plated deck here. Now that is your airflow. You can see it is slanted, and it's gonna hit right in the center of the deck there, okay? So right there where your coil is at, right there where that squonk pin is, that's where your coil is gonna be, and then that airflow is gonna go right underneath it. All right. So now the only thing I found problem with mine is this black one does not fit. See, it's already getting stuck. Okay. Let's go ahead and put it on here for a second anyway. Now, what I do most like about this deck, you can see the O-ring right there on that one. All right, what I do like most about this deck is you see those two slots up there. Now, those two slots are your starting and stopping points for this RDA. And I know everything is super, super juicy. So, it is gonna stop. It's not going to go any further, and it's not going to go any further here as well. So it does help for tightening down your RDA and taking it off, because it will just lock up and come right off with it. Okay, now those two slots in there, they will line up with the edges of this deck, and that's pretty much it. That's pretty simple. That's how they get it to lock. Okay, so my only problem with this one is this cap just, watch, I'm going to put it this way. See, I mean, I can't even get it on. Now, it's so hard turning. This thing is all juiced up. And, you know, as you can see, I did get it over there, but it is a pain. So I don't use that cap anymore, but all the rest do fit just fine. Okay, that one's a little stiff. And the silver one, it fits the tits. And slides just perfectly. So, you know, that's really the coolest thing about this deck, is that you really can just do a lot with it. You know, you can really, really accessorize. I mean, you've got, let's put this one over here so you can be seen, but you have all of these accessories. And this chamber reducer, this will go around here. And this is why I do not like it. All right, so it goes around here. And then when you go and put your, oh, it does still stop. It wasn't stopping for me before. Okay, so it does reduce the chamber just a tad. And it actually does still lock. I must have not have put it on right, but then when I remember trying it and it didn't lock, and I was like, I'm not gonna use that. Okay, one thing that I like about this deck is when you have something like a fuse Clapton that's flat, and you go and you put it in there, you screw that down, it's not going to tweak it. You do not have to bend your leads in order to make this fit. They are going to be able to just slide right in, and you'll be able to just screw them right down. So that's one thing I do like about, you know, this deck, the way they did do the deck, and they did make it so that the screws are going to go in the right way. All right, yeah, I think that's pretty much it. So let's do a build. All right, we're going to be building with these fuse claptons right here. Okay, we got 228 gauges on the core, and we got 38 gauge on the wrap. All right, so that's it. Enjoy some music, and I'll see you back up top. I'm a psychopath, I'm a killer, 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 killer. A psychopath, I'm a killer, 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 killer. A psychopath, I'm a killer, 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 killer. A psychopath, I'm a killer, killer, killer. I'm never keeping it plain. Lyrical murder is something I've been about ever since I was a little kid. Doodling in class, drew a picture with my teacher, bullet in his head, ruler in his ass with a toilet in front of him, throwing up, pissed off. Probably symbolic of this thought, sick talk to my inner enemy in the rough. I'm having nightmares of leaving behind my dreams with anything less than a full bank. It's like I'm General Hung and I'm standing in front of a gun. I'm putting myself in the way of a bullet to pull rank. The hood is over my eyes, but the wool ain't. Yeah, got the mentality of being with a wizard. Every award show, we don't even get considered. How do you sell something that's so lyrical to a kid who wouldn't know what was hitting if it hit him? Hit him. Now I wanna talk about these niggas from Detroit. Before me and Shady, who was thinking about Detroit? We put the world on tour, so watch how you say fuck me. You just might jinx yourself. Whoops, your girl gon' do it. Cause I was in the 9/11 in Chicago, 9/11 at the same time. I had already been grinding since 9/7. That's longevity. And if you take a lyric, you better be a killer. I'm a psychopath, I'm a killer. Oh, you ain't never killed a motherfucker, get real. A psychopath, I'm a killer. Killing automatic, but everybody's sporadic. A psychopath, I'm a killer. Cause ain't nobody killer. No, ain't nobody for real. A psychopath, I'm a killer. Drinker is the ringleader. I'm a deep thinker. I'm a street preacher with a street sweeper full of heat seekers and your G speakers. I'm a key bringer. I don't need heaters. I got the meat cleaver. Welcome to the slaughterhouse. Niggas try to tell me I spell too much. Capital S to the left to the T E R. Ho U S E. Now go to hell, you fucks. Word. Making work disappear quick as magic. Abracadabra, the traffic of blacker than Africa. Can you imagine a nigga flipping bread for the blood? Money like Dracula has him a spatula. Ask me a question. Am I the best with the flexing? Fuck yes with the goon talk. I just moonwalk all over the beat. Then I'm like no street, crooked girl, Michael Jackson, no thriller. I'm a psychopath, I'm a killer. Killer. You ain't never killed, motherfucker, get real. A psychopath, I'm a killer. Killer. I'm automatic when anybody's sporadic, I just. A psychopath, I'm a killer. Cause ain't nobody killer. No, ain't nobody for real. A psychopath, I'm a killer.
Making me want to set your daughter on fire with a soldering ironing. What up, mom? Applying for the rim job. Are you hiring? I'm hoping to fill up your opening. Oh, but I know I gotta meet a lot of requirements. First, I gotta accept you're in a lobby in Ireland. And you probably already been with all the slaughter. And I am in no mood to be playing second fiddle. Slob on this violin with no strings attached. I'm just a product of a hostile environment. But being brought up so brought up inspired. But I don't know why I still like I'm caught up inside a whirlpool. Not an appliance, but applying the science. I psychotically rhyme and it's like stars have aligned. All in alliance, heart of a line, balls of a life. Obscene talking, it's twine like a beanstalk in a vine. But I keep walking the line between the wrong and the right. But everything I write seems wrong. And it's like I'm ecstatic at all the static that I can still cause in the fabric of our modern society. Now Catholics are panicking because I snap back to my old annex and shenanigans. Damn it, the Pope's mad again. Probably shouldn't have ran up in the Vatican with that mannequin singing bagpipes from Baghdad again. And my dad's dragging a faggot in a glad bag. Won't be the last time I make a dramatic entrance like Vatican. You thought I was lying when I said I think that I'm crossing the line again. I've lost my mind, Carson. Oh God, I think I just thought of another fucking line. Forgive me, Father, for Iceland. But hip hop has left me brainwashed with a violent street defiant. Now the odds of me trying to fucking be quiet probably gotta be about as high as the Jolly Green Giant after he's fallen.
Hey there, YouTube. We're back up top with the B2K. We got it on the pulse, 80 watt. And ooh, let's go ahead and have a vape.
Now, the juice that I got in here is cornbread pudding. And if you ain't heard about this stuff, I have a review coming up for it pretty soon, but you should go out and get this stuff. This stuff is amazing. We're not talking about that juice right now. We are talking about the B2K, Born to Kill, 187 edition. Boom. Thing. It's pretty badass, man. I mean, you know, one of the best features that I like about it is that little locking top. For this, kind of locks it between the two positions. You know, where you got fully open, fully closed, and that's it. You just pretty much can't go no more. You pretty much just can't go no more than fully open, fully close, and then adjust it to where you want it. So for me, that's pro. You know, I really do like that, especially when it comes for when you're taking your top cap off or when you're putting it on. It allows you to grip and not just spin the top cap, just spin the barrel, just keeps going and going and going and going and going. So, you know, when it comes to that, this thing is just killer. The flavor on this thing is, you know, it's definitely one of a kind. It is probably as good as the Wasp Nano, as the Cyclone Entheon, better than both of them. But, you know, it does have some downsides that, you know, you can just squonk the shit out of this thing. Now, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to give it a nice hard push. Now you should see it coming out right about now. Let it go, and it should get sucked back in. Boom, you heard it right there. Now, you can do a nice big squonk, but you have to be attentive, you know, at least to the airflow holes when you are doing your squonk, because that juice will come out. So, you know, as long as you do it that way, as long as you're paying attention, or at least, I mean, I know me, I don't ever squonk it like that. You know, I do little small squonks that I, you know, I know how much is coming out. You know, I've gotten used to it. I've taken the cap off a million times. You know, I've just done it a lot. Like a lot. So, you know, I know how I like to squonk. And I don't really like to squonk too much like that either, because then the deck gets a little floody and you get a little spitty. So, you know, I'd rather not do that. I'd rather just, you know, do little smaller squonks. You know, as long as your wick game's on point, you ain't got to worry about nothing much. So, yeah. Now the price point for this thing, you know, I would say is a little bit on the higher end. So this is the fourth edition. They, you know, currently they're on the fifth edition, which we will be taking a look at very soon. I got that one right there for $60. You know, I would say that this thing's pretty much a steal. You know, it does come with a ton of things on top of the fact that it's very flavorful. You know, and I know it seems kind of, you know, just redundant, right? Like, you got all these things. Why do I need 4 or 5 different top caps and 8 drip tips? You know, I would have said that same thing at one point. I would have said the same thing, but now that I got a lot of different mods, and everything's all different, and you can just make it match differently. You know, I mean, I kind of feel like back in the day when you got a new Barbie and you got to dress her up. No? No? You guys? No? You guys? Oh, I mean, you know what I meant. You know, when your sister got the new Barbie and she was, dude, that's what I meant. See, you guys know. You guys know me. You guys know me. It's hot in here. It's getting a little hot. But now I'm just playing. But yeah, you know, it's just, it really does allow you to get up in there, you know, change it up, you know, do some different matching. Now, obviously, it's going to be more standard matching, you know, unless you go out and go get a different cap. I know I've seen one red one on Pal702's channel. You know, he's busted out a few times in the videos, and that's the one that I want. That one looks badass. But I haven't really gone down that road yet. I haven't done that Google search yet. But I'll get there. I'll probably do it one day. You know, but getting slam caps is, you know, normally pretty easy for a lot of these, you know, RDAs like this. Especially these really popular ones. So the only other thing I would mention about this one is I do believe it could be a fake. You know, I bought it on eBay because I wanted the 187 edition, and that was the only place I could find it. You know, and that's exactly why I think two of the caps that came with it don't fit right. You know, the black one, which is, one of the nicest ones to want to even use. That one does not, you know, fit at all. Just, I mean, I pretty much feel like I'm going to be scratching the gold if I keep, you know, effing with it and pulling on and off and even trying to adjust the airflow. And then I do believe it's the white one as well. It's tight. Fits, but it's tight. I don't know if it's a fake or not. You know, I'm going to guess it is. That's what happens when you buy shit on eBay. But, I mean, otherwise it does hold up completely, you know, to the one that I, you know, to the B2K, you know, the 5th edition one. And that one is real. That one I did get on Mike Vape's, you know, website. So that one is real, but he did not have any more of the gold deck. He was out of stock, and I'm pretty sure everywhere was. That's why I just went down this road. I did a Google search, ended up on eBay, and I said, you know, I want it. And the taste, the build quality is still there, you know, except for those two caps. You know, everything is, the build quality is great. You know, it's identical in every single way, shape, and form, except for just those two goddamn caps not fitting.
I would highly recommend that you go out there and get, you know, it definitely, I mean, the flavor is just there. You know, it comes squonk ready. You don't even have to install the squonk pin, you know, which to me is a pro. You know, that's a big pro, because, I mean, everybody, the squonking thing is just taken off. You know, everybody is squonking now. Why send an RDA, you know, with a squonk pin not installed? You know, even when I bought the Rage with the Rebel RDA, the squonk pin wasn't installed, but I bought it with a squonker, right? Like, I bought it with a squonker. It was a kit. And it still didn't come installed. So, you know, to me, that's a pro. You know, just having that installed just from the jump, you know, it's a pro. But the machine quality is just amazing. One thing I would say is it's not really an RDA. I wouldn't use it as a dripper. You can if you drip very, very moderately. And it's not because it's going to flood. You know, that airflow is really angled at a good angle. So, you know, you don't have to worry about flooding too much. I mean, if you overdrip, you will flood. It's a very small deck. You know, even with the angled airflow, and you know, you got cotton in there taking up space, and it will flood. I mean, it's a small deck. I'm pretty sure it's a 23 millimeter deck. So, you know, it's really small. The main reason you don't want to, because it gets very spitty. It just gets very spitty. And you know, and if you're dripping on this thing, you know, the chances of you having that spit guard on here, that's pretty slim. I would say pretty slim, because you can't drip with that thing on unless you take the effing drip tip out all the time. But, it's just not really fun taking this drip tip in and out all the time, especially when it starts getting all greasy. It's a very small drip tip, and all that grease that you get right underneath, you know, where your 810 connection meets, you know, that is where you just start getting it all over your hands and all over the mouthpiece, and then it pretty much starts slipping off every time that you try to go take it off, if you are going to drip that way, because I did try it and I did not like it. So I don't really drip with this thing at all. It's just strictly for squonking. Too much, you know, juice in the deck. It will flood it, and then you get a lot of it in your mouth. And we all know how fun that is. We all know how just fun it is to get all that spit back, and I try to, you know, to purge it. I wouldn't recommend purging this one either. We'll go ahead and do it and show you why, but you know, because of that angle, you can guess where it's gonna go. I'm guessing I don't have to tell you where it's gonna go. Yeah, so no purging for spit back on this one. Now, normally, I guess if you want to purge to alleviate some of that spit back, and you don't mind it coming out and getting all over your mod, then that's fine. You know, I don't purge for spit back. I don't really purge at all. My mods, the iJoy Genie, that one takes, you know, it takes a minute to get going. So
I will purge that one because I need to know when it's ready. I need to know, you know, that I can pull now. You know, otherwise I don't really purge unless I'm using that mod. You know, all my other mods fire so quickly, so I don't purge, but don't purge with this thing. I mean you can. Like, if it's a dare, I mean, go for it. But guys, this thing is great, man. This is a great, 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 great RDA. You know, I have been testing out a couple more RDAs lately, and I haven't been taking this one to work with me. But when I go to work, I take this one, and I take my other one. And I have both B2Ks on different devices all day long. All I have to say about the B2K is that the price point is a little bit high, but everything that it comes with and the flavor that you get out of this thing, you won't regret it. You know, I didn't regret it. I bought two. Really put it down. You know, I have a couple other RDAs that I'm testing out right now, and I'm ready to be done with their videos so I can just go back to using the B2K a little more. Yeah, all the pros are there. You know, the machining is great. The layout of it is great. You know, the way that you put your leads in. You know, if you're running, you know, coils like Fuse Claptons, you know, or Aliens, you're not going to tweak your coil when you go and tighten down your lead. So that, you know, it's all pros. You know, it's definitely not a dripper. So if you are looking to drip and you're looking for a dripper, you know, and you want the flavor, I would say go with the Wasp Nano. You know, this one is just not meant for dripping. It's just too small. You know, it gets too floody too easily. And in my opinion, you just end up wasting your juice. And you can learn to drip on this, but you're gonna be dripping a lot. So, you know, thank you guys for watching. You know, I got it up here, Wicks and Wires. I will link it down in the description. You know, I'm not gonna link exactly the one I have because I got it on eBay. We already talked about that. I don't even know if it's real. I don't think it's real. Part of me doesn't think it's real, at least as far as those two cop caps go, but everything else is just flawless. You know, the taste is great. Yeah, vapor production. Flavor. All really good. All really good. Oh, but you got cornbread and pudding in here too. Ooh. It's a little bit of a game changer with that stuff. So check it out. Wicks and Wires. You know, that's where I'll link it down there. And thank you for watching. And I'll catch you on the next one.